Well, folks, big news in the land of the investigations into Donald Trump and his company, the Trump Organization. It's been revealed now that a second grand jury has been impaneled in the state of New York, in addition to, obviously, the original grand jury, and that's the one that handed down the indictments against the Trump Organization and Allen Weisselberg just a few months ago. The fact that they have impaneled a second grand jury is huge. Now, of course, all the legal experts out there want everybody to know that this is not a guarantee that charges are going to come against Trump. It is not a guarantee that indictments will come. It could go on and then nothing come of it, and that's fine. That does sometimes happen, sure. And I think everybody understands that, okay? I don't think these legal analysts and legal experts need to give us that caveat every time. But they're also optimistic that this new grand jury means they're going a new route and have basically opened up what could be considered to be a second investigation. And here's what that means. Those close to the investigation, those who kind of have a good feel of what's going on. And of course, the grand jury is secret, so we don't know exactly what they are looking at. But those familiar with it believe that this grand jury is actually looking into whether or not Donald Trump overinflated or undervalued his properties for either loan purposes or tax purposes, which means this grand jury might be looking into potential bank fraud, potential tax fraud, probably both. Because we have seen stories, story after story after story recently, that shows that, yeah, Trump undervalued this property. Trump overvalued this property. He did it with insurance. He did it with local tax agencies. He's done it a lot. And of course, Michael Cohen had hinted at this not that long ago. And Michael Cohen, for the record, I think he gets out of house arrest in just 13 days. So we can probably expect to see a lot more from him in the coming weeks about this investigation. Either way, the first one, let's not forget, that was kind of looking into like individual taxes, right? That one really did kind of hone in on Weisselberg. You got all these gifts, you got all these perks, you didn't report any of them on your personal taxes. The Trump Organization didn't report them, so boom, we got you here. Bank fraud, tax fraud, those kinds of things, that's a whole different animal. And you don't want to bombard a jury or your investigators with all of these different things that are totally not related, you know, similar, but really not in the eyes of the law. So that is why you would impanel the second grand jury, because you're basically bringing in a different group of people, presenting them just a limited, subset of the evidence to say, hey, we're going to bring this to you. You tell us if you think this means X, Y, or Z. And these people will not have been clouded by everything that happened before, you know, all the other evidence they had seen, like the other grand jury did. So that's likely why this happened. We also know that the Manhattan District Attorney Cy Vance is involved in this, as is New York's Attorney General Letitia James. This is big. This is bad for Trump. And hopefully this is the one that leads to indictments. But I gotta tell folks, you do need to temper your expectations. Not just because it may yield nothing, but because it's been impaneled for 6 months. They've already put a time frame on it. These people are going to be there for 6 months. So don't expect anything soon. They clearly have a lot of evidence to go through. So it may not be till March or April of next year that we see any kind of indictments coming down the pipeline.